Good morning. Once again, we've got quiet conditions here to talk about this morning. And I don't think I'll get tired of that. I'm sure you feel the same way after our active weather recently. It's nice to have a stretch where there's not much to talk about. We're looking at some conditions that are going to be, once again this morning, starting off with some slick roads. There are places where we're below freezing, not as cold as yesterday, and places where we've had fog develop again. It's another morning where we're dealing with a dense fog advisory, and it's now been extended. We're seeing this for all of eastern North Dakota now, including the James River Valley, Devil's Lake, Grand Forks, and Fargo, right on the edge of this. And you just saw our visibility in Fargo, at least looking east, is okay. Over to the east, we're doing just fine. So we've kind of flipped things a little bit here. I'm actually going to pop back to that advisory because looks like we've had more counties added to it just a few moments ago. And that's why we're seeing some flashing indicating an update. Looks like a couple of our northwestern Minnesota counties, Kitson, Western Walsh, Western Polk, also added to the advisory. And you can see why. Our visibility is at zero now, and this does stretch all the way along the border toward Candu. Cooperstown, we're at zero for visibility. Devil's Lake, a quarter mile. Fargo, it's lower, but we're still doing just fine in Fargo, at least. And checking out your wind speeds, we're seeing some wind coming in out of the south, very light. That's helped to contribute to the fog development, and temperatures dropping quite a bit, too. You can see where it's much colder. 19 in Hallock, 18 in Langdon, and 17 currently in Devil's Lake. Fargo's at 31, and it's 30 degrees in Grand Forks. So a lot milder to start off our day this morning in the south and over to the east. I mean, temperatures in the 30s to begin in the morning. That's something we haven't seen in a while. It's been quite cold lately. And checking out your radar and satellite map, you can see it's quiet right here in the valley. Still some lingering clouds, a few areas where we've got even a little snow that was showing up in Roberts County. And expanding the view, unfortunately, some of those same areas that are trying to recover from some serious flooding in Nebraska and back into Iowa, well, there's some moisture headed that way. So they're going to be dealing with another round of stormy weather and rainy weather there. We are north of that storm track here in the valley. A look at your hour-by-hour planner. Expect today to have mostly cloudy skies with some sunshine in between to start off this morning. And we may even get some moments where we're more on the sunny side here. But you could see another round of clouds drop in by the 4 o'clock hour with temperatures in the mid to upper 30s. So above freezing again today. Melting a little bit more, ripening up that snowpack a little bit more, and heading into the 7 o'clock hour, temperatures into the mid-30s, and even this evening, still hanging on to some 20s, to some 30s, with partly cloudy to mostly cloudy skies. By tomorrow morning, we may see more of that fog develop again, and conditions looking a little bit more on the murky side, on the Minnesota side again of the Red River. A little breezy along the river and west of there as that wind picks up, so that might prevent us from seeing much fog in some spots. And then heading into the rest of the morning and into the afternoon for your Wednesday, which, by the way, is the spring equinox, the first day of astronomical spring. We'll have some spring-like weather, some temperatures back above freezing, more melting happening, a little bit of wind that should ease up as we head into the evening hours for Wednesday night. So here's your photo. I love this one. This is that sunrise near the Buxton Bridge in North Dakota, Buxton, North Dakota. Tom, thanks for sharing that. And in your 7-day planner, more spring weather, more conditions on the rise, or warmer temperatures. We're going to see some 40s Thursday and into Friday with quiet conditions through the rest of the work week. Even Saturday looks really good. As we head into Sunday, though, that's when our next chance for some rain moves in. We're looking at some rain showers Sunday, and then that lingering into the week on Monday as well, with a few showers affecting us. Temperatures at that point, this is critical. Your morning lows, both Sunday morning and Monday morning, will be above freezing. So that will, we are hoping to get some above or temperatures below freezing overnight to kind of slow that thaw process. But this might start to speed things up. So something to keep an eye on as we work our way little by little toward more spring-like weather coming up.
All right, looks good. Thank you, Lisa. If you need to release some stress, then stick around. It's coming up. We're talking about Fargo's first axe throwing company.